Hey everyone, Colin Smith here from PhotoshopCAFE.com, and the time's come to test Photoshop and Lightroom on the brand new Apple 16-inch M1 Max. So we are gonna test this puppy out. We are going to be running the latest version of Photoshop, which is gonna be Photoshop 2022 and also Lightroom Classic 2022. On the machines, our contenders are the 16-inch MacBook Pro M1 Max, which is running 64 gigs of memory, versus the 16-inch MacBook Pro, the previous flagship. And this one is running 8-core Intel Core i9s at 2.4 gigahertz, 64 gigs of DDR4 RAM. And this has the 8 gig AMD Radeon Pro 550M. We have the 13-inch MacBook Pro M1 with 16 gigs of memory. So this was the previous best M1 that was available inside a laptop. So we're gonna put these through various tests in Photoshop and Lightroom. We're looking at this image, which is a PSB. It's 3.6 gigabytes. It's 9,500 pixels by 6,000 pixels. Contains 68 layers. Also contains smart objects with smart filters. So there's a lot of stuff going on there. This is a very heavy file. And so for all of these machines, I had them plugged into power and everything was loaded onto the local desktop. So we're not looking at any of the writing speed on the ports or anything like that. So from the desktop, the 13-inch M1 did this in 13 seconds to open it. The 16-inch Intel took 16 seconds to open this. And the 16-inch M1 Max, 9.9 seconds. So opens significantly faster, looks like the drive is better. So then what I did is just a quick stamp visible just to kind of get one layer that we could work with for some different things. So that's essentially crushing all the layers down and creating a composite layer. So on the 13-inch M1 and the 16-inch Intel, about the same, about 3 seconds, took 2 seconds on the Max. Now we're going in, we're doing a GPU empowered filter. So we're doing the smart blur, and the smart blur can be quite difficult to compute. So what I did is I set this to a radius of 50, threshold 25, and then chose the high quality. The high quality will really take a lot longer to process. And so as far as we're looking at this, the M1 13-inch did this in just under 2 minutes, 1 minute and 55 seconds. The 16-inch Intel definitely crushed it there. It did it just under 1 minute, 59 seconds. And the 16-inch M1 Max, yeah, 34.6 seconds. So then I did a flip horizontal, not just a single layer, but the entire canvas, so it has to redraw it. So the 13-inch MacBook Pro M1 took 12.63 seconds. The 16-inch Intel, 17.5 seconds, so quite a bit slower there. And the 16-inch M1 Max, 6.95 seconds, twice as fast. Now, the interesting thing to note is on the previous test, on the older version of Photoshop, we are seeing significant performance increases because the 13-inch used to do this at 48.93 seconds, whereas a 16-inch MacBook Pro did this at 35.7 seconds. So this is the previous version of Photoshop. So the new version is actually quite a lot faster too. That's worth noting. All right, moving on. All right, so here's the thing. Now we're resizing this by 300%. So that's making it 3 times as large using Bicubic interpolation. So this is gonna take it to a 28,000 pixel by 17,000 pixel image. And also it has to do the smart objects. So all the smart filters have to be re-rendered as well. So this is very computationally heavy. So let's see how we did. The 13-inch did this in 2 minutes and 40 seconds. The Intel 16-inch, not surprising with much more memory, did this in 1 minute and 29 seconds, so just over 1.5 minutes, just under 1.5 minutes. And our M1 Max did this in 55 seconds, under a minute. So this next test is really testing out the CPU. And the way to do that is to use, believe it or not, the zoom filter, the radial filter, because that is not optimized for GPU. It's really taxing the CPU. And in fact, all three of these machines, when I looked at activity monitor, the CPU was every single one of the cores was working to the max for the entire process. So this is a good test. So let's have a look at the results. So the results of this is the M1 13 inch did this in 5 minutes and 31 seconds. So the 16 inch i9 Intel did this in 5 minutes and 14 seconds. The M1 Max 16 inch did this in only 3 minutes and 10 seconds. So significant improvement there in CPU speed. Then we decided to save these. Once again, this is very computationally heavy. The M1 13 inch took 4 minutes and 25 seconds. 16 inch Intel, 4 minutes and 2 seconds. That 16 inch M1 did this in 3 minutes and 40 seconds. So we're starting with a 9-image panorama shot from the Sony A1. So each photo is 50 megapixels. We're doing this inside Lightroom Classic 2022. Okay, to see the preview, took the M1 13 inch about 30 seconds. The M1 16 inch and the Intel 16 inch did both these in around about 12 seconds. So then I turned on fill edges. So it has to do content aware fill and build out the panorama. It took the 13 inch M1 58.45 seconds, so almost a minute. The 16 inch Intel did this in 42 seconds, significantly faster. And then the 16 inch M1, 29.16 seconds. So hands down faster than both. Then I took these images and I opened them as a smart object inside of Photoshop. Now this is without Photoshop being open. So this is including launching Photoshop. And the final size of these is 21,000 pixels across by 7,000 pixels high. So this is a really big image. So it took the 13 inch M1 13.23 seconds, which is really fast. Faster, in fact, than the 16 inch Intel, which did it at 19.1 seconds. Then the 16 inch M1 Max crushed it at 8 seconds. So one of the things that people say is difficult to do is the neural filters. So I decided to run the neural filter on this large image and we did the landscape mixer. So the 13 inch M1 did this in 14.2 seconds. The 16 inch Intel, 15.55 seconds. And the new 16 inch M1 Max, take a guess, 4 seconds. Wow. All right, so we can see on these tests that I've ran that pretty much in every category, the M1 16-inch Max is crushing both of these. So there's a couple of things I'm noticing here. The battle of the 16-inch from the Intel, which is top-of-the-line Intel, to the top-of-the-line M1, there's absolutely no competition. Another thing that's maybe not quite so surprising is seeing the difference in the speed from the original M1 with 16 gigs of memory to the M1 Max with the 64 gigs of memory. So we can definitely see huge improvements here in the M1 Max over the original M1. So as I said, when I did my first review on this, I said the M1 is amazing, don't buy it. Man, I got some flack for that. And the reason I said that is, if you guys remember, if you're a consumer and you're doing Word and things like that, the M1 is fine. If you're a professional, wait a little bit. And so we've waited a little bit here, less than a year. And now we have a machine here. Let me put that in the middle because clearly this is the winner, which no surprise. But this is ready for pro work. It's ready for prime time. The 64 gig, 16 inch M1 Max is a beast. It's ready for your heavy lifting as far as any Photoshop Lightroom work. I don't hesitate to recommend it for that work. Now I'm going to do some more tests with some other things, including some video tests. So let me know in the comments underneath. Number one, what do you guys think of this? Is this a beast or what? And the second thing is, what would you like to see me test for my more in-depth review and also looking at video and other things as well? So anyway, guys, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Consider hitting the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any videos from me. And do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm and also let your friends know about this. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.